Please tell me everything's all set.
Not exactly.
What do you mean, not exactly?
I just have a few last-minute details to work out.
Lorraine, I need somebody to switch those sonogram results or my entire life is going to go down the drain.
Wait here.
Where have you been? It is almost 4 o'clock. You know, he's going to be here any minute.
Carly, guess what? This is a hospital. We're in the business of saving lives, not switching sonograms.
What are you telling me, Lorraine? You're not going to help me?
No. I just had to twist a few arms to work it out, that's all.
Well, you're the best.
Yeah, and as we all know, if you want the best, you got to pay for it. So it's going to cost you 300 more.
Fine. Whatever.
You'd see it that way. As it turns out, there's a patient coming in who happens to be due in December, so this is perfect.
To make it look more convincing now, when you come out with the sonogram pictures, please give them to the guy who will be sitting next to me.
You're such a piece of work, Carly.
Look, I have a lot riding on the outcome of this, and I'm not letting anyone screw it up for me.
Welcome to the House of Miracles. Ready for yours?
Everything's set.
Just like we planned it.
You know what to do?
I said yes.
Okay, well, right after the ultrasound, you switch my results to somebody else's so it looks like I'm having my baby in December, and then you give those results to the guy who'll be waiting with me.
Relax, Mom. Your angel of mercy is on the case.
Lorraine?
Mr. Margaret.
You're supposed to be working in the extended care wing. Why aren't you there?
Oh, actually, Jeannie McKenna and I decided to switch assignments. You know, just for today, of course.
According to Jeannie, you browbeat her into doing it.
Oh, no. Sister, I would never do that. No, Jeannie and I had a very nice conversation. She said she was more than happy to go along.
Well, none of which means any difference to me. Now, you were assigned to extended care, and that's where you're going. Immediately.
Yes, I know that switching assignments is against hospital policy. It's just that I couldn't be in that ward today, sister. I just couldn't.
And why not?
Dr. Barron, you know, he criticizes everything I do.
Dr. Barron's one of the finest doctors on our staff.
I know, and I respect him tremendously. It's just that our personalities don't exactly complement each other.
And I suppose you're going to tell me that's Dr. Barron's fault.
No. No. It's mine. I know that I rub people the wrong way, and honestly, I've really tried to work on that. It's just some days, sister, it's just too hard.
All right. But the next time you have a problem, bring it to me first. We can't have our nurses changing schedules whenever they please.
I promise you, sister, that's exactly what I'll do.
Very well.
Back in business?
Well, that was close, wasn't it?
Very. Now that we have a few minutes, why don't you fill me in a little? Why are you trying to scam some guy about the due date?
I don't really want to get into it.
Are you kidding me? After what I just went through, the least you could do is tell me why.
I'm trying to convince some guy that he didn't get me pregnant.
No offense, sweetie, but it usually works the other way around.
Look, Lorraine, it's a long story, okay? I'll give you the details when everything is done.
Who's the sucker, Carly?